Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And this is going to be a really cool video. I'm going to teach you how to create websites on your local computer. And typically, this is actually how I'll build a website. You can obviously start building your website on your web hosting account, but it's a little slower when you do it that way, and it's so much faster if you build and test websites on your local machine, and then when it's ready and perfected and fully developed, then you would migrate that website from your local computer to your web hosting account. Now, there has always been several ways to do this. There's something called, it's pretty technical, it's called wamp, and then there's xampp, and those are ways of installing a web server on your computer and all this kind of stuff, and it's very technical and a little complicated, but there is a new solution out, and it's actually not a new solution, it's been out for a while. The only thing that's different now is the product was purchased by a company called Flywheel, and they took this product that was $129 per year and they made it completely free. And here it is right here. It's called Local. It was probably named Local before Flywheel bought it. But now it's called Local by Flywheel. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to install it and start using it. So what this is, it's right now, unfortunately, there's only a version for it that works on the Mac computer, but they are also developing a PC version. So depending on when you see this video, the PC version may be out. And what I'll do is I'll have a link and an update in the first comment down below. It'll be a pinned comment, and that's where I'll have an update link to this page, and also when the PC version's out, I'll update that comment and make it say the PC version is out, just so you know, because I know the majority of people that are watching this video probably using a PC computer instead of a Mac, but I'm a Mac guy, and it's Mac only for right now, but very soon it should be on a PC as well. But the procedure to actually use the program is going to be the same whether you're on a PC or a Mac, most likely. So here it is, and essentially we just install it, and it creates these little virtual containers for your website. You can have unique settings per website. You can develop more than one website on your computer at the same time. And what is really neat about this, and I haven't tested it yet, but I know someone that has and told me about it, and I was blown away. Say you are working on a website on your local machine, but you want to show this website to someone else that maybe it's your customer or a business partner or maybe a friend that you just want to get their feedback on it. There's this feature where you can create a link that they can actually, that you can send to this person outside of where you are, and they can click on it and actually see your website. Now, this is a very difficult thing to do normally because there's routers and firewalls and all these types of things that will block connecting or being able to share your website. It's just very complicated, but this has that all solved for you, and it's right here. It's called Simple Demo URLs. So here's some of their little bullet points on this. This is something that a lot of developers are switching to. I use a different solution right now to have websites on my machine, and this is the perfect time to try something new. So anyways, all you have to do is come to this website. I'll have a link down below to it, and then click where it says free download, and it's going to give you this pop-up where you just got to put your name and your email address in, and then click on the get it now. And what it's going to do, you're not going to actually receive an email with a download link. It's going to immediately start downloading on your computer. Now, obviously, we're giving them our email address. However, Flywheel, the company that bought this, is an established company. They're not going to do anything spammy, so I really wouldn't worry at all about giving them your email address, and I just gave them my email address. Now, when you download it, it's going to be a zip file, and here it is right here, and it's a pretty big file. It's let's see if I can stretch this out. It is almost 500 megabytes, and so then you'll need to unzip it. You'll have this, and you can drag and drop it into your applications folder. Now, when you open it out of your applications folder, this is what you'll see, and this is, I've done everything up to this point already, so we're going to go through this together. So what as it's saying here is when I click on this Let's Go, it's going to download everything it needs to download and configure it for me. So I'm going to click on it, and let's see what happens.
I have a pen. I have an apple.
All right, it's all done, and it probably only took 2 or 3 minutes. Now, I have a pretty decent internet connection, so it was pretty fast for me. There are better internet connections. I need to just upgrade. But anyways, this is it right here. And so the first step is going to be to click right here where it says Add Site. And then let's put some information in there. So for site name, let's just call it example, like that. And it's going to give me a site domain right there. You know, I actually also have that other local solution to develop websites on my local machine. And I already know I have a website called Example. This is good to see if there'll be any conflicts. But instead, I'm going to actually change it to Example Website. How about that? To make sure there's no conflicts. So I'm assuming this local sites folder is probably in my user account folder on my Mac. It doesn't look like it's in my documents folder, but it looks like I could put that wherever I wanted. So now let's click on this little arrow here and see what our options are. So we get to choose our PHP version, which is pretty cool. It's a little technical. You're going to be real stable at 5.6. There are some plugins and themes that aren't going to work at 7, so I'm going to go down to 5.6, which is pretty cool. For web server, there's two different types. I'll just stick with what it has. A lot of your web hosting accounts are going to have Apache, though. And MySQL, I think I will just, actually I like this, how it's saying 50% of sites are typically this and 25% are that. I wish they would do that with the PHP version. Anyways, I'm going to go with 5.6, and so that's my environment options. And now let's look at the WordPress options. The first option here is if I want to do WordPress multi-site. Not a fan of multi-site personally, so I'll leave that as no. My admin username, I'll just change that to site admin. And for my password, I'll just go ahead and put the same thing, just like that. And then the admin email, I'll put my, just like that. And then I'll click on add site. Okay, it says you don't have, would you like to save what you entered as the default? Okay, so this is good. Actually, I like this a lot. It's realizing that this is the first time I've created a instance of WordPress on my local machine, and it's saying that it can save this admin username, password, and admin email as a default. So in the future, when I create more sites, it's going to autofill that in. I actually like that. So I'm going to choose yes. So now it's creating the site, and you could see it happening right now. I wouldn't imagine this would take that long. And so let's see. Alright, that whole process took about 1 minute. I sped it up for you, and let's see what we're looking at. It's just a recap of everything that we chose and some options here. So let's see. It's showing me my site setup. Here's my database information, SSL if I wanted to install a security certificate if I was building an e-commerce site or anything like that, and some utilities right here. So here's that demo URL thing. I actually want to test that. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click on admin. All right, so here I am. I'm at that website I created. So let's log in. Well, here I am. I'm already logged into the site, and it did install the latest version of WordPress, which is what I wanted. And so that's it. So let's see how it is downloading and installing some themes and plugins. So for a theme, I will download and install the GeneratePress, which is one of my favorite themes. I'm going to click on Install. And let's see how fast everything is. Okay, so that's already installed and activated. Let's install a plugin. One of my favorite plugins is the free page builder called Elementor. And there we go. I'm going to do that. And they just hit 30,000 active installs. Congratulations, Elementor team. And let's install this and activate that. And let's just create a quick page just to see how fast this works. So I'm going to go to add new. Let's call it home, like that. And I'm going to just get my page set up for the page builder. I'll click on publish. And so when you're developing locally, when you update something or save something or any of those types of activities, it's just going to work a lot faster and a lot more reliably. So I'm going to go ahead and click on edit with Elementor. Let's see how fast this works. Wow, very fast. Let's see, add a template. And let me see, I will add one of these really nice looking templates. How about this one right here? This is fine. This is a landing page. So I'm clicking on it. Now, when you do install a Elementor template, it actually has to go out to Elementor servers and download some pieces of information. And it looks like it's doing it now. This is actually how long it normally would take. And then let's go ahead and click on save. And let's go to view the page. And there it is. There's my page all done in this new solution called Local by Flywheel. So let's pull up the app again and see if it's possible to demo that really cool feature. So say you're developing this website. Now you want to get some feedback, right? So I think it was utilities. And then I would click on this demo URL, click on enable, and let's see what happens. So it gives me this URL right here. So I'm going to highlight it and copy it to my clipboard. And I'm going to open up a new tab, paste it in, and let's see what happens. Now, if this works, it's pretty stinking amazing, because your workflow before is, if you wanted to develop a website on your local machine, there's like next to no way to show that to anybody to get any feedback. It's a very hard thing to do. So let's see what happens. I'm going to hit enter right now. And oh my gosh, this is beautiful. Let me click on home and that should show me that. Oh my gosh, this is amazing. This feature right here is enough for me to want to switch to using local versus the solution that I'm using right now. This is amazing that I can click on this right here and it will give me a demo URL that's public. Now, here's something really cool. Well, and it's public and you didn't have to, I mean, you can be at a Starbucks coffee shop as long as you're connected to the internet on your computer, you'll be able to share it. But what's really cool is now, if I want to get feedback, I can now click on disable. And that link is now gone. Let's see what happens. So I'm going to go here and click on refresh. And there it is, page not found. And here's going to be interesting. I'm going to enable it again and see if this changes. I would assume that it would. So if I enable it again, now it's a totally different URL. So if I refresh this, it's still not working. I would have to copy and paste in the new one, like that, and it's probably going to pull right up, and there it is. I got to tell you, so far, that one feature is the one thing that I knew could potentially get me to switch to use this, and it works pretty flawlessly. So I'm going to disable it again. So what that allows you to do is so much. I hire designers to build out pages with Elementor, that page builder I was just showing you, and with this, I could give them access to log in and add that template, and it's all on my local machine. I think that's a pretty useful thing. So anyways, now let's just take a look at the settings here. So here are those default settings that it saw that I was using for the first time. So the next time I go to create a website for demo purposes, it's going to autofill that in for me, all of that site, that stuff. So I think that's going to be pretty helpful. You can export. So let's see. Looks like you can do some exporting. There's some advanced options. You can create blueprints, and that's pretty neat. So you can set up your kind of your stock WordPress install. So for me, it would be WordPress with Elementor and GeneratePress and any plugins that I would use regularly, and I can make that a blueprint. So when I want to start a new site, I can start it off of that blueprint. I don't have to manually install WordPress again and the themes and the plugins and do some default configurations. I can do that all as a blueprint. That's pretty cool. Add-ons, it looks like they're going to have some add-ons, and I'm sure that's how they might want to make some money off this stinking thing in the future, is to maybe have some add-ons that add some more features. But right now, it's pretty amazing that you can do all this stuff. So I'll click on sites. Now, I think with this program, when I'm ready to stop using it, I think I could probably just close the program. I don't know if I have to click stop all. So let's see. I just closed the program. So when I click on refresh, I would assume I can't access anything. And right here, let's see when I hit refresh. Actually, that might not be the case. Okay, go to dashboard. How about that? Oh, it's actually still running even though I closed the application. That's interesting. So if I wanted to open it up again like this, and here it is, I guess to stop a website, I have to click on stop all. And there it is. It's going to stop it. It says stopping. And now my website is officially stopped. There it is. Very cool. Very cool. So anyways, this has been Local by Flywheel. It is a free program that you can get for your Mac, and just be a little patient. I'm sure they're going to have that PC version out really soon. When you scroll all the way down to the bottom of this, and it's telling you all these great things, and it tells you about this pro version that they're working on. But when we scroll down right here, it says right here, when will it be available for Windows? And it says soon, very soon, because it says so soon. So anyways, if you are using a Mac computer, this is definitely the way to go to develop websites on your local machine for speed and security, and just getting everything done a lot quicker using the blueprints, and then being able to share it with these private links. It's a pretty amazing solution, and I think you are going to love it. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm going to give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3-Step to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.